in the heart of Milan, a forest of light. Grown out of a collaboration between Swedish clothing brand Cause and architect Su Fujimoto. The Salone de Mobile is the world's preeminent furniture fair, showcasing the cutting edge in product design. But the most Instagrammable moments are not tables and chairs, but installations like these created by major brands. With suspended watch pieces, Citizen explored the theme of time, while Nike employed tent designers to investigate concepts of natural motion. And Airbnb created a shared dining experience with utensils designed by up-and-coming talent. Into the fray now come the fashion houses like Marni, who know they have to reach beyond clothing and accessories to satisfy the needs of high-end consumers. And now, crystal maker Swarovski has decided to enter the game, employing top architects and designers to create pieces for their first ever homeware collection.
Crystals distribute and radiate an aura that is unlike any object in the world.
I mean, what's amazing about the material is this incredible depth and this clarity and the refraction of light.
It is a very seductive material, you know, what it does to light.
It's not the light of a lullaby. It's not a light of the twilight. It's the light of life, something which is exciting. Look at the adrenaline light in the veins of the geometry of a crystal.
One material in the hands of three designers. The result? A chess set, a series of glacial centerpieces, and a collection of playful bookends, each carrying the unique imprint of its designer.
It's about working with materials, not forcing materials to do something, but working with them in a way which is incredibly energetic and powerful.
Designing duo Fredrickson Stallard are leading exponents of British avant-garde design. From crumpled metal consoles and shards of mirrored glass to glacial tables and rock-like velvet sofas, their objects aim to capture the beauty of naturally occurring destruction.
The Glaciarium collection that we've designed for Atelier Swarovski is based on very powerful, raw, natural, chaotic forms of the material of crystal itself. The orchid vase and the centerpiece have two very energetic pieces of crystal fused together, and these beautiful fissures, and that's something that hasn't been done before. So by bringing that in, we're moving what Swarovski does into the 21st century.
Look, how much design has gone into a mosquito? And how much design has gone to an elephant? It doesn't take less time or less magic to design a small pawn in a chess set than it does to design a large-scale city plan.
Daniel Libeskind is one of the world's leading architects, most famous for the Jewish Museum in Berlin and the master plan of Ground Zero in New York. He's an architect with a long-term fascination with crystal, designing a museum in Ontario and a shopping center in Las Vegas, directly inspired by the material and its interplay with light.
My idea was to create a chess set out of architecture, out of my architecture. So each piece of the chess set is actually a representation in space of a skyscraper. Even the pawns are small skyscrapers. And I thought that was appropriate because if you think of chess, it's a game of strategy, as is architecture. The famous scientist Kepler, who discovered that the orbits were not circular but were actually elliptical, discovered that every snowflake is a crystal and that every snowflake is different. That's magic. That's the crystal. That's the idea of the chess set.
The challenge is to avoid kitsch. That's the only challenge.
Ron Arad is one of the world's leading product designers, known for his radical reconception of furniture and his constant experimentation with metals, including aluminum, bronze, and steel.
As I said, what can I do that people will actually want in crystal? And I thought I'll make the alphabet. That got me into designing the font, the crystal font. And it was important that just stable. So they were both, I mean, all the letters were bottom heavy and then sort of lighter at the top. When you work with crystals and you get lots of unexpected happiness, like different colors being refracted from the room and stuff like that. So yeah, I mean, it was, I don't want to do a swan, but I don't mind doing an S.
For Swarovski, the hope is that these objects will one day adorn the homes of the stylish elite. Like this one here in New York, where my journey now ends. I finally found my friend Naomi and joined her at a cocktail party she's hosting with Demi Moore at a friend's Park Avenue apartment. And it's from here I bid you farewell.
My next episode's in Rome, so I'm gonna give you a little Italian. Arrivederci.
Arrivederci.
how do you say beautiful woman? All right, Bella?
Bella
Naomi.
I need to say something really naughty there. But Rome's great. I was raised in Rome from 1 to 4.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
I'll make a wish in the Trevi Fountain for
Please
you.
Please do. Mwah. That wasn't an air kiss, see?
Ciao!